The second generation of the CALF 3D VR180 camera has arrived, marking a significant advancement in consumer immersive video technology with 8K resolution and a lightweight pocket-sized design at a more reasonable price. I'll show you the most important upgrades and changes, so let's jump into it. The third generation CALF camera launched as a Kickstarter project with 6K video resolution and the capability of shooting different stereoscopic formats like 3D or VR180. It's a bigger and heavier camera with many extra features like a big touchscreen, several inputs and outputs, various mounting options and professional in-camera settings, obviously targeting professional creators. At the same time, the second generation camera is more lightweight with a cleaner design, mostly focusing on point-and-shoot content creators. Ease of use is another area where the CALF camera shines. The intuitive controls and streamlined workflow make it accessible even for newcomers to VR filmmaking. The camera has two 180 degrees ultra-wide lenses on the front and a 3.5-inch touchscreen display on the back. Thanks to this feature, we get a live preview while taking photos, recording videos, or live streaming without needing an external device. Additionally, you can only see a couple of buttons. With the red button, you can turn your camera on and off. The button with three lines opens settings, while the back arrow button allows you to step back in the menus. You'll find the microphones on the sides, a headphone jack and two USB-C connectors on one side, while on the other side there's an SD card slot and a lens socket. However, there's no access to the batteries, so the removable battery is gone. Instead, we've got a high-capacity built-in battery which supports recording video and live streaming for 2 hours on a single charge. Of course, we can charge with a USB cable during operation. This clean exterior design also hides easy handling inside. In the second generation CALF, you'll find a fully automatic shooting method with no such detailed options as in the first camera. Exposure settings and white balance are set automatically with a built-in color profile without any options for fine-tuning. To turn on the camera, long press the red button. Swipe to the center from the side and the menu will appear. On the left side you'll find the gallery with your photos and videos, while on the right you can select the shooting mode. After selecting one, a record button will appear in the middle of the screen. This serves as the shutter button in photo and video mode, while in live stream mode it displays as a start live button. On the left you'll find the settings menu with only a few options. In photo mode you can set a delay if desired and select the safe path. The camera has built-in memory and you'll see how much space is left in the top left corner. Of course, you can expand storage with a microSD card. In video mode you'll find similar options, but you can set the bitrate from 10 to 100 megabits per second and choose between fisheye and ERP modes. ERP mode is the same as the VR180 mode in the first generation CALF camera, with a content-aware mask around the fisheye image, while fisheye mode is a raw video from both lenses, with back borders and a little bit more fisheye distortion on the image. When discussing 360 or VR cameras, remember that these image sizes refer to the entire VR space. In this case, it's divided between the images of the two eyes, but with 8K, it gets closer to the picture quality as if you were seeing it with your own eyes. So going higher and higher in resolution is crucial in VR, but let's see it in practice. In my previous CALF review, I made an in-depth comparison between that camera and the Insta360 Evo. This time I will compare the new model with the previous version. I mounted these cameras together just like I did with the Evo and made some test shots. But I wouldn't say this is a fair comparison between a prosumer, a professional camera, and a consumer camera. But I'd like to highlight some points in this comparison. Here you can see the image quality of both cameras, with the first generation CALF on the left and the new camera on the right. I used the image of the left side lens of both cameras after upscaling the 6K footage of the previous version. And as you can see, there are a lot of differences between them. It seems like CALF didn't keep anything from the previous model, so we see different color science, dynamic range and contrast. In this model, they solved the red glare issue, but maybe the first thing you might observe is the difference in saturation straight out of the camera. I must confess, I like the color science and the slightly undersaturated look of the original CALF camera, as it provided many opportunities in post-production. But don't forget, the new model is mostly targeted at the consumer market, and most users don't want to bother with editing and color grading. They prefer an appealing look straight out of the camera. So as you can see, these cameras have different image styles. Besides different saturation, the colors also look very different. The new CALF camera has cooler colors with a greenish tint, slightly more details in the highlights and darker shadows, resulting in a more contrasty image but with a little bit less dynamic range. With a bit of color grading, we can bring them closer for better analysis, but the difference is so big that it's challenging to get them really close. Anyhow, here you can check out both videos at 100%. Don't forget, we're comparing a 6K and an 8K video, so besides observing in 100%, I zoom in on the first generation CALF video a bit more to get the same framing and see the differences at this level. But after this short pixel peeking, let's return to ergonomics for a second. I don't have any problems with the ergonomics of the original CALF camera. It's a bit heavy and big, but I'm used to this with other professional cameras. This extra weight and bigger size provide a better feel during handheld shots and can help avoid small handshakes too. On the other hand, the compact and pocketable camera is an excellent traveling companion. Thanks to the built-in gyroscope, you can always keep your camera level, which is crucial in creating immersive content. And as I mentioned from the beginning, despite the same manufacturer and brand name, these cameras vary in almost all aspects. The original CALF camera was made for higher budget productions, targeting professional or prosumer users. The second model is a consumer product in a lower price range, with no manual recording options and fewer shooting modes, but with improvements like 8K video, pocketable size and weight, and built-in gyroscope, serving point-and-shoot content creators and travelers. I'll continue testing this camera and compare it with the Insta360 Evo. Until then, if you have any questions, write me in the comments. And if you like this short review and comparison, please give a thumbs up. And for further 360 content and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. And see you next time!